Good morning, everyone. On this busy morning, I would like to greet all of you and thank you so much for joining us today. I would like to firstly apologize for having joined the session at this time. We had some mix-up with the links with the session in the Liasa office. I sincerely apologize for the delay and thank you so much for holding on until we actually start the session. Can you confirm if you can hear me from your side?
Good morning. Yes, loud and clear.
All right, thank you so much for the confirmation. I am also sharing my screen. Could you also please confirm if you can see my slides?
And not yet, it's a black screen.
Let me do that again. Still the blank screen.
Yes, still a blank screen.
Annalisa, let me just see if I can share from the from PowerPoint myself.
Thank you so much, Yanush.
No, my thing seems to have locked up.
It says it's you are starting to share your screen. Is it also giving you a blank screen?
It's telling me it's paused. So okay, can you see my screen now?
Yes,
Yes,
we
we
can now
can.
see the
Yes, we
screen.
can.
Okay. Let me start the show. Okay, Annalisa, I think that's as good as it's gonna get for now.
All right. Thank you so much, Yanush. Again, apologies, everyone, for all the hiccups. We really apologize. We wish we could go back and make things better, but going forward, we'll ensure none of this will happen. So welcome to our prompt engineering workshop series information session. So thank you so much for signing up for the session that we've advertised and promoted through our Liasa channels and through the UKS Librarian of the Year's Facebook page. So today's session is just an information session into giving you insight as to how we plan to conduct these workshop series and what the benefits are and how you can enhance your knowledge on artificial intelligence and prompt engineering. My name is Annelisa Mentemphako. I'm the current UKS Librarian of the Year. Outgoing soon, as a new Librarian of the Year will be announced during the Liasa conference in the next month. This is my project under that portfolio, but I currently work as an open scholarship manager at the University of the Western Cape Library. So, as part of the Liasa UKS Librarian of the Year Award, the recipient needs to host a project where they can contribute to capacity development, digital literacies, any project that they feel it's worth investing on. So for me, I thought it is very important that we establish these workshop series for librarians to benefit in terms of enhancing our skills regarding prompt engineering and how we interact with these technologies in our everyday lives. Next slide, Janusz. Okay, so this project is a collaboration between myself and many other colleagues of mine. Some of them will not even be on these slides, but I would like to introduce you to my key partners, Mr. Janusz Krasinski, who is my colleague. We work together at the University of the Western Cape Library. Janusz is an information specialist and works as a faculty librarian for the Arts and Humanities faculty in our library. His research interests are artificial intelligence literacy as well as research support. And I would also like you to introduce you to my co-facilitator, who is Sylvester Jeffries, who is a learning and teaching specialist. And some of his interests include critical literacies and e-pedagogy and user experience. So between Janusz, Sylvester, and myself, we will be facilitating or co-facilitating the upcoming sessions together. So with some sessions between week one and week four, it may be myself, Janusz, or Sylvester, or in some sessions you may find us collaborating in delivering the session. Next slide, Janusz.
Okay, so
Okay, I'm actually going to hand over to Janusz to go through this slide.
okay, well, thank you, Annalisa, and welcome everybody to our workshop. I hope we are going to be able to impart some useful information and educate us you all on how to make best use of this relatively new technology. Of generative AI. So just to kick off, we've got a couple of sort of general questions that come up in reference to prompt engineering and generative AI. And so if we wouldn't mind if you can maybe just maybe pop in the chat whether you think these statements are true or false in regard to generative AI and prompt engineering. So I'm going to give while I waffle a little bit longer, are you welcome to sort of start popping your T's and your F's into the chat. So the like I mentioned, I'm going to be talking mostly in the sessions about the background of the generative AI and how it's sort of evolved to the stage, and so while Sylvester and Annalisa will cover some of the more technical elements of the actual developing of prompts. So the okay, so we've got one response so far. Yeah, so the first one is it all about just asking questions? And the short answer is no. Whilst most of us have communicated with a chatbot, and that is generally about asking questions, prompt engineering is more about developing a set of instructions for the AI to interpret. And it's not, I'm going to answer number six now. It is not a static process. It evolves as you go through the series of questions. Then can anyone do it without training? Well, we'd like to believe not, since we are offering you the training. You can sort of obviously pick up a few hints along the way, but the actual syntax and if developing a prompt to be effective does require a little bit of training. And is it only for programmers? Initially, that was the belief, and it does. I'm not going to say it doesn't hurt to have a little bit of programming background. I've done some Python programming, so it does help me understand how the generative AI like ChatGPT interprets information that you upload, so I can then at least understand the back a little bit of how it is processing, and that way you have a better understanding of what to upload when you're asking to read a file. But anybody who is able to write an instruction can become a prompt engineer. It just requires a little bit of training, like I mentioned before. And prompts are not a one size fits all. Different generative AI models understand different instructions, so you also need to tailor what you are writing to the tool that you're using or the model that you're using. And the AI does not always understand prompts correctly. So I'm sure you've all, any of you who have had the experience of using one of the AI tools will be aware. It can misinterpret what you're saying quite readily. As I mentioned before, it's not static. It has to evolve along with the model, as well as depending on what your outcome is. They are not always text generated. You can upload PDFs, spreadsheets. It can generate images. They're getting more advanced where they can interpret audio files. It is changing almost as even overnight. There'll be a new tool, a new interpretation. And can it replace human creativity? It sometimes feels like it could. But in reality, no. The human it is simply a tool, and we as humans at the moment are still controlling it. And our interpretation, it requires us to create that prompt, to ask the question. So whilst we are still writing the prompts, we still have the control. And we are still the creative force behind what the AI is generating. Think of it as like a really advanced word processor, if you like, that can make those little suggestions as you go along. But at the end of the day, you're the one creating that content. So the overview of this particular project and how we are. Annalisa will talk a little bit more about the structure. But so we are going to start off just looking really at what is the generative AI, what it how it's, it fits into that realm of both information technology, how it is how it's evolved, and how it creates content and how it generates output. Then prompt engineering itself is then looking at basically being able to give the instructions to these large language models. We'll also look at large multimodal models that we'll cover in the first session next week. And look at how we can optimize our prompts to be more effective, use less resources. I hope we are going to touch a little bit on the ethics and as well as the resources that generative AI is using in order to we need to look, obviously take into account things like sustainability. And that is something that we are also going to touch on during these sessions. And then critical AI literacies. We need to, it's both being able to understand what the AI is doing in the background, be able to put and make informed decisions about using artificial intelligence and AI technologies. And looking then at also, obviously, like I mentioned previously, the ethical, social, and other and privacy implications of making use of generative AI, and how maybe the differing models and differing who owns that technology, who owns that information. So it's quite a lot to cover, which is why I think we're breaking it down into like sort of chunks, and hopefully you will enjoy the sessions that are coming up. I'm going to hand over to Annalisa now to talk a little bit more about the workshop structure.
Thank you, Janusz. All right, so yes, colleagues, in terms of having chosen this particular topic, we really felt that it's one of the current hot topics that fortunately impact how we perform our various duties in the different libraries that we are located in. So we felt that if we could set up this workshop series, we could all benefit as librarians, regardless of which libraries or lines of information work we fall under. So we thought we can have a series of workshops so that if you feel the most basic session, which is the introduction to generative AI, is not really for you, you can skip it and then maybe perhaps sign up for the next one or any other of the other more sort of advanced sessions later on in the project. So we have sort of made it flexible so that you can choose which ones are applicable to you and which ones you would think that they would benefit you the most. Although we do encourage that you sign up for all the sessions because at the end we also have a certificate of participation that we would like to give to you if you happen to complete all the short assessments as well as attend the sessions and engage with our learning resource. So you can only secure that certificate if you complete all the sessions and the short assessments that are associated with each session. So as Janusz has mentioned, it's quite a lot to cover. So there is no way that we thought we could achieve this with one session, which is why we broke it down to four sessions. So today's session, as I mentioned at the beginning, it's just the information session to tell you how we're going to proceed forward and an opportunity for you to ask questions before we can even start. Then next week, we are going to actually start our session on the introduction to generative AI and prompting concepts. Then the 2 weeks after that, on the 27th of September, we're going to look into designing effective prompts and techniques for AI chatbots. So now we're going more deeper into the various chatbots that are there and how we can apply our knowledge of generating prompts onto each of them. Then on the 11th of October, that's after the LIASA conference, then we are going to try and master what we've built up and up until this session. So all the basic prompt skills and recipes that we will have established up to the 11th of October, we will try to polish those up and sort of create a prompt recipe book for each person or all of us that we can use and apply in our daily tasks in our various libraries. Then we will the last session will focus on creating the custom prompts for the diverse library scenarios. And throughout these sessions, we will be also seeking input from you so that we can address or try to cover all the diverse lines of librarianship that we have. So we will be sort of requiring feedback from you or asking for prompts or asking for scenarios that you actually struggle to create prompts for so that we can use those as examples during the sessions. Next slide, Janusz. Okay, so the main objectives for this workshop series is we would like to be able or enhance our ability to support patrons in digital literacies and navigating AI tools. As some of us may be aware, whether you are in a public library or you are in an academic library, patrons are approaching us to request assistance regarding the use of AI tools. And even academics in institutions of higher learning, they are sending students to the library. So we do need to familiarize ourselves with the limits and the skills that we need. And very important, what Yanush mentioned earlier, the ethics and privacy issues that are associated with the use of AI. So this workshop series is also aiming to address that. So instead of generating new prompts every time you need to complete a task, we'd like to develop a skill set where we are able to automate routine library tasks to improve proficiency. So spending more time generating new prompts every day for tasks that you've previously completed is actually what we're looking at enhancing. So we want us at the end of this workshop series to have a resource, each of us, that can draw prompts from every time. Let's say if you're generating reports every month, then there is no need to be prompting AI tools to complete some minor tasks for you, whereas you can store all those prompts to just update every month or however the frequency of generating reports is. Okay, so I'm not saying we must generate all our reports from ChatGPT or any of the other popular AI tools, but I am making this in reference to a task that all of us in this workshop series could be required to do each and every end of the month or on a weekly basis. So those are some of the prompts that we would like to get documented so that you don't do repetitive tasks that can be simplified into automation. We would also like to achieve maintain a leading edge in AI and prompt engineering skills. We all of the knowledge that we collect or generate from this session is obviously to improve and offer innovative library services using AI to better serve our different communities. And also, as the landscape is changing, you may find that going forward, we need to capacitate ourselves as librarians so that we are suitable and we align with new job demands in terms of our career progression. Next slide, Janosh. So session one, which is next week, will be the basics of generative AI and prompt fundamentals. So this will be the very basic overview. So anyone who's new to the topic or would like to gather the most basic information, this session is for you. We'll be introducing a generative AI and its applications. Then we will move over or get deeper into understanding the basics of prompt engineering, like simplifying it and explaining that prompts actually refers to the input that we put into our AI tools to generate a response or output. So we will be unpacking a little bit of that so that we understand and we don't scare you off with this term that is prompt engineering. And then we're just going to unpack the key concepts and the terminology so that we move together as a collective. Next slide, please. 2 weeks after the first session on the 27th of September, we are going to look at designing prompts. So the title of the session will be Prompt Designs and Techniques to Instruct AI Chatbots. So at this time, we will have identified a few chatbots. Again, depending on your feedback and input of which chatbots you're familiar with or which one would like to explore, and also looking at their limitations. So we will design effective prompts for AI chatbots, looking at the capability and limitations of each chosen chatbot. Then we will look into techniques for instructing AI to achieve the desired outcomes. That's where we will be looking at prompt techniques such as using the persona, giving the prompt instruction for context, as well as the format of the response that you would like. So we will be just going a little deeper into actually designing the prompts to generate the desired outcomes. Then again, from your input, we are going to use practical examples. I see someone on the chat had mentioned that let's look into generating prompts for librarians who are doing systematic reviews. So these exactly are the kinds of input and feedback that we need. So we're going to ensure that we address that particular one that is mentioned on the chat. Next slide, Janusz. Okay, on our second last session on the 11th of October, shortly after the LEASA conference, will be advanced prompt engineering techniques. So this session is simply a build up from the previous session. So after having established the generic understanding of creating prompts, applying personas and applying prompt techniques, then we're going to start to be even more practical and get our hands dirty by looking at real workplace applications, and also try out complex prompts that some of us may struggle to even put together. So it will be like an exchange where we offer each other expertise and advice, and also advise each other in terms of which prompts are suitable for which chatbots. Because in the two sessions that we are going to cover the limitations of each chatbot. So sometimes we struggle with prompts, not because the prompt itself is of poor quality or is lacking in some aspect, but because we are instructing a chatbot or an AI tool beyond its capacity, which is why in the first two sessions, we are going to look at each chatbot's capacity before we actually apply the complex prompts. Next slide, Janusz. Our last session will sort of be a showcase of our prompt recipes that we will have generated or created over the 3 weeks. And this obviously applicable to our different lines of work will be a showcase of the scenarios as well as the different operations that we can simplify using our generated prompts. So we will build on or touch up on creating prompt recipes, which should be your takeaway resource after the entire series of this project. So you should go away with a recipe book, if you may call it that, that has all your prompts that you can apply into real work operations. We will have different examples, and we will also have a collaborative session where we discuss the different prompts and also try to see how we can simplify them or assist any participants who are still struggling with generating prompts for their particular line of work. So that will be our last session, and hopefully by this time we will all be on the same sort of on the same level in terms of the understanding and the practical application of the prompt recipes. Next slide, Janusz. Okay, so for the 4 weeks, I'm now going to hand over to my colleague Sylvester to explain to us how we're going to proceed forward in terms of the mode of delivery over the next upcoming 4 sessions. Over to you, Sylvester.
Thank you, Annalisa. Hi, everyone. So let's talk about how we're delivering this exciting workshop. It essentially will be a balanced mix of live and flexible learning that I hope will fit around your schedule. We have some synchronous sessions. These are our live fortnightly presentations, the dates were given, where we will do demos, have discussions, we'll try and do some hands-on activities during those sessions where we work through examples together, as Annalisa has explained. You can think of it as a real-time library workshop, but in the comfort of your own space. And we will certainly make sure that you get the right links. On the other end, we will also have asynchronous components to it, where you can access all the materials that we've prepared, where you can go through these at your own pace through our e-learning resource, where we'll be making use of a lib guide. And essentially there you could also just learn how you could make use of your own lib guides in terms of creating e-learning resources for interactivity or engagement from your participants. So that component will be perfect for revisiting key points or catching up if you can't make a live session. And we will also provide you with recorded sessions via the LIASA YouTube channel. And that essentially is if you'd like to revisit or catch up on these live sessions, you'll have access to everything you need, just like consulting past conference proceedings, if you may. Next slide. Okay, we will also be providing a certificate of completion. However, we have some requirements attached to it. Nothing too complicated. Firstly, what I will be going through next is just a pre-workshop questionnaire that we would like to run with you. Essentially, you have from today until next week, Thursday, to complete it. Hopefully, the sooner you can provide us with that information, the better, because that will be factored into us finalizing our fortnightly sessions. Like Annalisa had mentioned, if there is anything that you would like to see come up in these sessions in terms of the examples or the recipe of prompts that you would like to design, we would like to use some of the information that you provide us through this pre-workshop questionnaire. It should take you 10 minutes plus minus. And yeah, that will also just help us understand your current level of knowledge. There's no grade attached to that. It's just to make sure that we're all on the same page. Okay. The second requirement is that we have a session quiz challenge. So after each session, we would need you, and that it doesn't have to be directly after each session. It can be, you will have 2 weeks to complete it just before the next fortnightly session, where you need to take a timed 10-minute quiz. So that is also quick and straightforward. You don't need to worry about a minimum grade there. So even if you don't score well, it just gives us a sense that you are engaging, or if there is a lack of engagement, it's just good for us to see how you are interacting with the materials or the content or the sessions that we are providing. Then the final requirement will be a summative quiz, which is or will be provided to you right at the end of the series. And yeah, we would like to see that you score at least 75% in order to get the certificate of completion. This is simply for you to demonstrate your mastery of this topic that we are going through. So yeah, we would appreciate if you do your best to complete all these requirements in order to qualify for that certificate of completion. But for the session quiz challenge, or challenges for those four quizzes, for the four workshops, you will also be able to download a certificate that says that you did take part in that specific component. So we have we're not expecting you to take part in every workshop, but we highly encourage that you do your best to take part in the complete series, and not just one out of the four. Yeah, we feel like you will gain a lot more out of it in that way. Final slide for me, please. So this is the pre-workshop series questionnaire that I just spoke to. One of my colleagues will share it in the chat box. Please could you try and complete that as soon as possible today, over the weekend? The sooner we can get that information, it will aid our understanding where everyone stands with AI and prompt engineering. Yeah, kindly complete it. There's no graded attached to that, no pressure, just a little insight for us to adjust the workshop content as we go along. Thank you, everyone, and I look forward to seeing you online over the next four sessions. Handing
Thank you
over to
so much. Thank you so much, Sylvester, for taking us through the mode of delivery and all the expectations. And obviously the benefit from engaging in all of this setup. Janusz, participants have indicated that they cannot access the link. I had shared it earlier on the chat. Could you please sort out the permissions of the questionnaire and then reshare the link on the chat, please?
It should be working now. I will reshare the link.
Yeah, just share
So
the new
if
link.
somebody could just double check for me, and let us know if they're still having problems, that'll be great.
Okay, no problem. All right, then, whilst we are waiting for that feedback, colleagues, thank you so much for coming through. This is now the time that I'm going to allow you to please ask us any questions if you do. If not, our contacts are up on the screen. If there's any questions or concerns during from now up until our next session, please drop us an email and we will try and see how we can be of assistance. But then, are there any questions at the moment?
Thanks, Annalisa. I'm Teresa. I just wanted to find out, in terms of planning and stuff like that, how long are the live sessions going to be?
Thank you so much, Teresa. Our live sessions, we try to customize our content and engagement so that it fits into an hour, which is why we said it should be between 11 and 12. But if I may share with you, we may have a slight change with one of our sessions because the national office has asked us to move the session to either before the already communicated time or after that, because I think there will be an event or a meeting or something on one of the Fridays. So one of the Fridays may, but we'll send an updated information to say if it will be between 10 and 11 or just in an hour after 12. I'm not sure, but I did get that confirmation. But as soon as we upload our next sessions for registration, we'll send that update, and obviously on the calendar it will reflect what time it will be. But
Okay.
the duration of the session will be 1 hour strictly.
Okay. Thank you
Thank
so
you,
much.
Teresa.
All right. And thank you for arranging this, as it looks like, yeah, it's going to benefit many of us. Thank
Thank
you.
you. Thank you so much for the feedback, Teresa.
Okay.
Any other questions, colleagues?
Hi, Annalisa, it's Joyce from TUT. I just wanted to find out if we're still gonna use the very same login details, password, and all the likes for joining the next session, perhaps next week.
Tigiledi, no. As we've mentioned earlier, we've sort of set up the sessions into
Okay.
different links. So each session will have its own different link. And we, for this reason, we would like to rectify what happened with today's session where links were mixed up. So for all the registrations, you will receive a new updated link for that particular session.
Okay, thank you so much.
Thanks, Tiki Lady.
This is Cecilia Walter. I'd like to ask a question, if I may.
Please, Cecilia, go ahead.
There are two things that bug me about AI. One is the black box of what these chatbots and so on are trained on. And the other thing is so many of these apps and chatbots and everything cost a lot of money. And it concerns me that if you're using several of them, you know, it's beyond what students and even lecturers in South Africa can afford. Will the chatbots, etc., that you're recommending be free?
Thank you so much for your question, Cecilia. Well, in terms of costing and access to the chatbots, well, there's variations where with some we can explore the free version, and then as you go deeper into what you want to achieve, then it asks you to pay. So unfortunately, we are going to try and work within the limits of what is accessible to the majority of the participants of the course, which is why it's important for us to please complete the pre-session form, so that we can determine, okay, how many people have got access to this particular chatbot and which ones should we rather avoid because of the complications of access. And also within our institutions, well, those of us who are fortunate in higher education institutions, there are some chatbots or programs that we do have access to by virtue of being a registered student or an employed staff member. But again, at the moment, I cannot give you a straightforward answer to say it will be the free or not free ones, but we will try and accommodate everyone so that we all benefit from this workshop series by looking at the fair distribution of what participants actually have access to from the feedback form.
Thank you.
All right. Colleagues, I am not going to to allow any or take any more questions since we are now running out of time. And as I've already indicated to Theresa, we do not want to go over the hour that we've asked from you. So we're going to end our session at this time today. And I look forward to seeing you on our first session. Thank you so much for coming. And if you've got any questions, please do make use of our contact details on the screen. Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone, for coming through.
Thank you, Annalisa and team. Thank you, everyone. Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks, everyone. Thank you, Pan.